Good afternoon, everyone. Well, it's a bright night. So, talking about Freak today, that talks about the human brain. And it says how wonderful this human brain is. And it never stopped working. From the moment we're born until the moment we stand up and give a speech on TED. Now my brain is not working properly, so. Talking about pressure and worries. It reminds me of a time like growing up as an Asian Chinese. You know, around the world, internationally, people expect you to get straight A's, always, all the time in math, you know. Where I get B's all the way straight to F. You know, to them, I'm like a fish who doesn't know how to swim. So, the university final exam one day, I remember a foreign exchange student came to me and said, hey, are you Asian? I said, yeah. His face just like a bright smile came in, you know. Can you help me with my maths? I said, no, I can't. I said, why? I said, I'm not an Asian. I said, well, but you just said you were. I pulled the exam grade and I said, I'm not an Asian, I'm Bijan. In fact, that day I was probably a Asian or Bijan. So why don't I tell that story? Expectation. Expectation from other people kills fear. Expectation from other people put us in prison. Expectation makes us slowly accept this current half-broken world. And with a new generation, we come to an event like this, love to talk about changing the world, but when we let expectation from other people become our dictator, we don't change the world. The world changes. So instead of living a life, we begin instead making a living. Instead of living our dream, we begin instead surviving in hell. Expectation will slowly just silence your inaction to enslave you. Until one day you turn and become See, I told you, my brain doesn't work on the stage. So, as I was saying, expectation will finally turn you into become an average person, an average nuts and bolts in this society. Timeless author Mark Twain once said, there are two most important days in our life, the day we're born and the day we find out why. And today I'm going to talk about these two most important days in your life. And when you truly grasp the meaning behind these 2 days, oh, you will live your dream. Not only that, you will change the world. So how did it all begin? Well, it began on the toughest day of my life as a small Chinese boy at school in Hong Kong. You know, the day where teachers just get the exam paper, just stack on the paper, and you know just about to read out your mark and grade in front of the whole class. You know, it was like the end of the world. My palm was sweaty, my legs were shaking, and as the teachers were on the stage, I could hear the pin drop. And I began to hear the whole class laughing at me, and boys and girls around me saying, oh, he's so slow. It's so stupid, it's such a retard. And when I heard those, I just felt defeated. I felt like I was nobody. And I couldn't hold it anymore, so I began started crying. And I was crying, so the teachers came over. She knelt down beside me. Said, I caused too much trouble, so she took me out on the corridor. Said, now, shut up, be quiet, causing too much trouble. So I stood there in the corridor, tears running down my face for like 1 hour. And that day, I went home. And I went straight to my mom. I yelled at her. I threw down my monster-sized school bag and I yelled at her. I said, why did you bring me to this world? My mother looked at me. She said, I didn't bring you here. You chose to be here. You were one out of 2 billion sperm in daddy's testicles. As she said, she was like wiggling her ass, showing me what a sperm is like. And As you reach out to the bookshelf, turn to the encyclopedia page where I've been secretly reading many times before. And she said, yeah, sperm? I was like, tears all down my face, I've never heard this before. She said, yeah, you're one out of 2 billion sperm in daddy's testicles. And you fought day and night, in the dark. You felt over and over again, it was slippery. You didn't give up. You didn't give in. And like every other sperm, you kept on going. You just kept on going and going. And you believed in yourself, and you won the most important race in your life. You were a champion. That night I slept like a baby, you know, just knowing I'm a champion. The next day I woke up, and I'm still traumatized by what happened in school. So I stood at the front door. I refused to go to school. My mom just reached out her hand and said, come with me. Let's try again. I said, no, I can't. She said, why? I said, because I'm slow, I'm stupid, and I'm just not good at anything. My mother came over to me. She looked me in the eyes and said, don't you ever say that again. Someone's opinion does not become your reality. I still remember she looked me in the eyes and said, I didn't force you to be here. You swam and won like a champion inside. You know, after I heard that message, I went straight to school. Happens I saw a crime boy, so I went straight to him. That's what I did. I told him the message and story of being a sperm. You know, that boy's face was shocked. He was like, what? He started using words like testicles, sperm, vagina, you know, normal words. Like a normal 60 who never heard of. And who would have thought many years later I'm telling this story with you all on TED. So, till this day, I keep a picture of the sperm to remind me of what champion I am. You guys want to see it? You want to see it? Someone's opinion does not have become the reality. We all have those moments in our life where we feel like we're not enough, where we feel like we're nothing. We all have them. You know, when the moment of defeat hits you, you begin to doubt yourself. You begin to doubt your ability, your potential. You doubt your ideas and dreams. You doubt even your identity or existence. Especially when pursuing something that other people think is impossible or inappropriate. But over time we begin to listen to these voices, and we listen to them every day, and we let someone's opinion to become our reality. Someone's opinion become our reality. Our six, from the moment of self-doubt to the moment of self-worth, is to realize what a champion you all are. Now, I learned that when I was 6 from my mom. That was one of the moments in my life that turned to momentum, that gave me power to move forward, to create a movement in my life. Now, what are the moments in your life? What are the moments in your life that can give you momentum to move you forward? What are those moments that allow you to experience your worth and to realize your worth? Is it a trip you went on to? Is it a person you talked to? Is it a book or movies you saw? A country you traveled to? Is it a relationship with God? Is it a personal experience or suffering? Find those moments. Find who you are. Now fear is going to be a play in your life. It's going to come out from nowhere. Like the moment I came on this stage, it's going to bite you. But you get to choose how much time you spend in your life imagining ghosts, worrying about the pathway into your future. But all there will ever be is what's happening here in the decision we make this moment. this moment and how we live our life, which is based on either love or fear. So many of us choose our path based on disguise as practicality. And when I hit 17, I chose my path based on fear disguised as practicality. I made it into one of the top universities in Hong Kong, went straight to study for the investment, you know, banking, factory, you know, ready to be trained to be another Wolf of Wall Street. Seriously, I was surrounded by people like that. But I failed again as a Bayesian. Felt miserably. In fact, my classmate was looking down at me and I felt defeated just like my 6 years old. Until one day I found myself sitting in the faculty dean office alongside the directors talking about my state of the and as I was sitting there, I can hear even some of them declaring how hopeless I'm going to be. And this free student just doesn't like my life, you know? So I was sitting down there, I'm looking at this flickering white light, I thought to myself, that's it. I'm going to get kicked out. I'm going to be a dropout. Just like Mark Zuckerberg, Bill Gates, and Steve Jobs. It wasn't like that, you know. I wish I could think like that. It was scary to imagine yourself get kicked out by university. Now, what am I going to say to my mom and dad? But little did I know I wasn't alone. Then, in the bottom moments of my life so far, I found people who just felt like me. But they just kept silent. But they're all around me. I began to meet those people in university, in life, in places, events like this today. Now, soon this bunch of friends begin to gather. We like to hang out at McDonald's and Starbucks, all about our dreams, our ambition for this world, what society we'd like to enjoy the free unlimited Wi-Fi there. So, soon, strangely, this is where Yes Network was born. Young entrepreneur, Society Network. Yes Network. Now from the student club, one day we were invited to train hundreds of high school students to start their first social project and social business. And I remember one of this really creative student group, they're just 15 years old. They would go out to Hong Kong and collect those paper cardboards where old ladies push around. They could collect it and make into really creative products, you know? Like environmentally friendly paper coffee, you know? Protect you. And you know how young people love to curse at each other? Like selfie, that day. And they're like, aha! We're going to call it selfie, don't we? Selfie. With a name like that, we quickly make it onto the newspaper. And soon, we were hired by university to train MBAs and PhDs on social innovation and create entrepreneurship. Including university who thought of kicking me out. So Yes Network transformed to Yes Network, the people you there. Where we begin to run workshop programs and boot camps for CEOs and top executives in banks and foundations in Hong Kong and China. It was very intimidating, but along the way I learned running the people incubator, the power to invest on people just like me, who refuse to fit in, who refuse to let someone's opinion to become their reality. I'm 21 years old this year. Now, did I face failure? Oh yes, I did. Was I ever humiliated for being my age in front of people and CEOs in their 50s? Yes, I was. Did I ever doubt myself being afraid? Yes. Yes, I was afraid. But all that were nothing compared to what I learned along this journey. From failing to be an Asian, to fail to be another Wolf of Wall Street, is that failing at something does not make me a failure. Not the least of which I can fail what I don't want, so I might as well take a chance doing what I love. Don't be afraid of failure, guys. You embrace it, you'll find yourself. Now along this journey, I realized a secret that many people walk the path of living their dream of changing the world. that is to realize everything we see around us that we call life, that we call the world, was made up by people that is no smarter than you. Find yourself. Find who you are. Find those moments and unleash your inner man and inner woman into your dream. I used to hate this word when people talk about it. A dream. What does it mean? Dream belong to those. Belong to those. D-R-E-A-M. It belongs to those who dare to realize enough to achieve more than what is given or told. Dare to realize enough to achieve more than what is given or told. Near the end of the day, isn't that the definition of being a freak? Those who dare to realize to achieve more than what is given or told. You can live your dream, or you can live your fear. And I think the joy of us is not living our dream, but living our fear. Now I want to ask you all a question. Close your eyes for a minute. Everybody, close your eyes just a minute. Imagine, what are your fears? What are you afraid of? What are you scared of? Because we all have fears, don't we? We all have something that is blocking us, that is holding us back. But as we begin to look in life, the number one reason why most of us are not living out our true potential or doing the things we really like to do is because of fear. Now open your eyes. Somebody once said, fear is false expectation appearing real. False expectation appearing real. Expectation. Now it reminds me of a time when I was a little boy. My parents would to walk me around in the neighborhood. This homeless dog who would be running around all the time. And every time you see him, he'd be barking and chasing me all the time. He'd be running behind my back and trying to bite my heels. And every time I see her, I run for my life. But these days it was just running at me again. So I started running. But I just got so tired of it. I was just like, every time I come and spend my life walking in the neighborhood. So I got and I picked up a rock and I threw it. I looked in his mouth, I looked in his gum, I realized that this dog ain't not got no teeth. He's got no teeth. And it was just like a grandma barking like, woo, 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 woo. Like, it was just, so I picked up a rock and I started running. He was running for his life. Little did we know, or little did I know, even looking back, that the majority of us spend most of our time in our life running scared. Running scared from something that has got no teeth in it. Because they are false expectation appearing real. We're brilliant at scaring ourselves to death. We're great at that. But until we turn around and face our fear and say no to it, and say yes to our potential, yes to our dream, yes to our unfolding future, or else we will continue to run, driven by fear, towards our final destination in life, death. Now a wise man once told me, he said the purpose to come to TED is to so that he can walk out that door one day to a TED. From TED, ideas worth spreading, to TED, lives worth living. Now a perfect combination. My mom taught me to love myself, to realize my worth. And my dad got into this book and to never fear. Someone's opinion does not have to become your reality. Moment, momentum, movement. This is the story of my life so far. Now what is your story here? What are your stories? Because I now look at you, all brilliant people out there, came to an event like this today is not by chance. You came here today. I see you all ready and able to do beautiful things to this world. I know deep down some of you know that already. And for those who still yet to discover, find your moments. Turn it into momentum. Turn it into movement. Whatever it is, start talking to people. Because when you walk out through those doors today after this event, you only ever have two choices. Love or fear. Choose love. Choose dream. Whatever it is, a business, a project, a job, or even a speech, like my mother has told me, you're all a champion here. You're all a champion. Don't ever let fear or expectation of other people turn you against your heart. Say no to fear. Say no to expectation and say yes to your potential. Yes to your dream and yes to an important future. For as one said, there are two most important days in our life. The day we're born and the day we find out why. Thank you so much. God bless you all.